Welcome, welcome to my channel. This is Clarity Empress, the Empress of Clarity, here to do another collective energy reading for my Clarity Empress Collective. Please like, share, subscribe, ring the bell so you can get notifications of any time I post. Comment in the comment section and let me know if the reading resonates with you. All right. Oh, all this time I was looking for this deck. It was right here. I guess it was meant to be. So, collective. What kind of energy are we pulling today on September? In September 2023. Well, that's a lot, but I'm not taking all that. All right, let's see. What are the messages Spirit would like me channel for you all today? What does the collective need to know, Spirit? Okay, past energy, pride and ego. It's either someone needs to let it go, needed to let it go, or has let it go. I got let go, or that was full of pride and ego. My bad. Full of it. Either way, they got to let it go. Pride and ego ain't going to get you anywhere no matter what you do. Okay, that's two cards. Somebody watching, stalking. Oh, because they recognize who you are now. Collective. So your person is on your social media. Any way that they can watch you and observe you, they are. Hell, this person could be on your ring light camera at your home. I don't know if y'all know it or not, but these ring lights basically tell your whereabouts, and they are in these community groups. I don't know how that works, but I know that people can see your ring light just like you can see their ring light. People post their ring light. So if you got that ring.com, ring light, whatever they call it, not ring light. You know what I'm talking about, the answering service with the camera. Just know that people can see you on that. It's not private. Not like you think it should be. It's for security, but it's not private. And somebody is watching you either on that, because I don't even have that. And I just feel like that's what they can see you on if they're watching you. So like if you don't have social media and you have that, you might as well have social media because they can see it. They can hack into it. I don't know how it works, but it's not private. Tell me more, Spirit. Now, I got admired in the challenge position, so I feel like they do admire you. They may even put you on a pedestal in that Nine of Coins energy. Vibration is here, so either they need to change their vibration, switch it up, raise it, or they have already started that process. Bottom of the deck, lessons. Okay. Somebody's learning lessons. So there is a situation. So you could take it how it resonates, of course. If it doesn't resonate, don't take it. But this sounds like somebody who has to learn their lessons with you. They already, I don't feel that this is anybody that you are speaking to. Because if they have to observe you from a distance, from your social, then you're not in contact with them. If they have to observe you in that way, that means that's the only way they can communicate. That's the only way they can figure out what's going on with you, is because they're too busy watching you. This person has learned lessons. That's the overall energy. Something about lessons with you. So you taught this person. You made this person a believer. You taught them a lesson. So Spirit said there was things that you said to this person in the past. They took for granted. They didn't believe you. Now they have evidence. Okay. I'll give you an example. One of my children, very headstrong, very alpha woman, straight up, you know, go for what she want. Young girl, young child, you know, still a teen. But I could say something one way, her father could say something one way, and she's still like, no, I feel like I feel, I think what I think. And, you know, I explained to her, we got way more mileage on this earth. And the reason why we say what we say is because we've had some experience. I don't pull a rabbit out my behind. I tell you what I know. You could take it however way you want to take it, right? And 9 times out of 10, sometimes 10 out of 10, she will have a fixed notion in her mind about what she believes. Hear me out. Disagree, only to come back maybe even a month or a couple weeks later and go, you know what, you were right, because, and she's now formulated a different opinion of it. So I had learned that I gotta let her live, meaning I can explain it to her my way, and then she gotta take it how she resonates. I feel like you tried to teach this person, and they didn't get the lessons until too after the fact, too late. Or after the fact, like you may or may not be too late, that's on y'all, but it was after you guys weren't speaking anymore that this person learned some sort of lesson that you were trying to explain to them. All right, so let's see what they, whoops, I'm about to drop the whole deck. Let's see what they want to be, you know, want to say or want you to know. What's going on with your person? The collective person wants to say experience. I play a lot of games. Just to see this back to the pride and ego, because I need to know if you really care or will you leave me. All right, so this person wanted you to chase them. This person would be the type of person to play in your face. I feel like they had a lot of attention from other people, but they wanted it from you. So they did things to see if they could trigger attention from you, if you would chase them. Maybe in the past you chased them, maybe in the past, you know, or it appeared that you were chasing them when you were just being genuine. But you know, nowadays everybody believes in a simp, right? Somebody who shows you attention and affection is simping, instead of just simply being a person. And this person, you may have simply been a human, genuine, unconditional, loving individual. And this person was like, yeah, that's not enough. I need you to keep going. I need you to show me more. And I'm going to go get some attention over here in your face while you show me some more. Tell me more, spirit. I know I have to take action, but what do I do? Will you accept me as I am? Gosh. So your person knows that, well, put it this way, they're watching you for an opening. They're hoping to be able to take action with you, but they don't know what to do exactly. And then they're at the same time, will you accept me as I am, is what they're saying. So this person may not want to change. You know, they may not want to do what's necessary for you all to have a deep and meaningful connection, because they may be saying, you know, I want to make a move. So this person could say to you, I want another chance. Will you give me another chance? But then don't have anything to back up what that chance is, or won't be consistent, or won't be long term before it's back to whatever it was that broke y'all up in the beginning, to begin with, put it that way. So this person, I feel like they don't know how to change, but they know who you are with recognition. Tell me more. You trigger me and I don't like it. I need to work on that before we talk again. So this is for you or your person, but somebody you know how to trigger. I feel like trigger each other. You guys probably triggered each other into a separation. And also, spirit is saying that you push this person's buttons in a way they couldn't speak on. You know, it's like they're already not probably good with speaking and communicating their emotions. And then here you go, just being yourself. You could be very attractive to them, and they might get you know, a little excited around you, and you may be like, no, I'm not that type of person, or whatever. And this person wants to be probably physically aggressive with you. And I don't mean like in a negative way, meaning they probably want to take charge that way and have a passionate affair. And you're like, hold on. So they're triggered because they're attracted to you. They may be attracted to you in multiple ways, but it still ends up a passionate thing with them because they fizzle out and they become inconsistent. They play a lot of games. They don't know what to do. Tell me more, Spirit. It says, I want to take you away from everything and everyone so we can reconnect in peace. This person wants your ear. They want to sit. They want to talk to you. They want you to hear them out. And they want to do it undisturbed. And they don't know how to do that. Meaning, if you're not speaking to them already, they're not really sure how to get your attention in a way that is just, you know, you and them reconnected. But that's what they want, especially with a Meyer. Tell me more about vibrations. I keep trying to find you another, but it but it doesn't work. I only want two. I'm laughing because this fell on the vibration. Your energetic signature is unique. You know how they used to say all the time that fingerprints are unique, right? Maybe they are. You know, everybody's imperfections and their fingerprints are uniquely different. But it's similar in the concept of your energy frequency. They will not find you in anyone else, no matter how hard they try. And I feel like your person has tried. So why they were, playing in your face with other people or other situations and not really committing to you, giving you the attention you deserve, and they were over there trying to get this person's attention and that person's attention or whoever, they were still searching for you. They probably figured I could find better. You know what I mean? They probably thought, oh, okay. Collective's cool, but this one is cute. Let me see what they doing. And then they don't be what, they still not you. Bottom of the deck, I'm not ready to grow up yet. I missed the carefree days when I had less responsibility. And that's the lesson that they learned. This person could not make up their mind, did not want to grow up, and that didn't get them anywhere. Because now they don't have the one person that they love. They don't have the one person that showed them love unconditionally. So this person is like in regret energy, I would say, with the lesson. It's kind of like, damn, I'm not ready to grow up, but then I can't have you. I missed carefree days when I had less responsibility, but you know, you don't get those days back. And a lot of people, either if they have a certain way, I don't know why I'm stuttering today. So I feel like if your person came to you, they might stutter because their brain is going to go faster than their mouth. You don't get those days back. I feel like this person wasn't ready to mature. But something about their childhood where either they had too much responsibility as a child, so it's making them difficult to want to grow up, or they were spoiled as a child and it's easy to stay the same because they like, will you accept me as I am? So if they're spoiled, they're expecting like, you know, you go along with it too. Like, you know, keep showing me you love me. But I feel like I don't see no give back. You trigger them. All they want to do is talk. And then they want to keep finding you and others. Your person is an F boy or F girl. Like, they really don't. They haven't matured. Okay. So you made a connection with somebody who doesn't know how to express themselves, that will ghost you, that's full of pride and ego, has to let that go. You trigger them because they're attracted to you, but then they can't remain consistent with you. Healthy choices. Making healthy choices in love, life, self-love, self-care, being happier. Yeah, your person, they didn't make healthy choices. They know that's what they should have done. I feel like you are making healthy choices now. You are choosing yourself. and being happier. And this person is like in their pride and ego, which is keeping them from you. And all they can do is watch you. Tell me more, Spirit. Please and thank you. They meet someone new. Okay, so I feel like your person wants to date you. That's why they want to take action. But they have to take the initiative. They really do need to take the initiative to set a date. They need to call you. You know, they need to see if you're available on that date. Pick a place. Have the money to, I don't know, treat you nicely, whatever that means. And or just have a time and a place for y'all to connect. I feel like that's what they want to do, and that's a challenge in the action. Challenging the lesson about this situation is they can't just find you in anyone. And they want to reconnect with you in peace. But I just feel like this peace that they want, based on what I'm seeing here, is that they just don't want any distractions from whatever they got to say. They want to isolate you a little bit. This person is really like, I'm hearing a lot. Isolate, brainwash, gaslight. So this person wants to make sure that your brain is completely wired to them. And they feel like the best way to do that is to isolate you when they talk to you or when they reconnect. Tell me more, Spirit. Chaser. The chaser, codependent relationship, fear of abandonment issue. So this person tried to make you the chaser in the past energy. And now they're getting ready to chase you, or they are chasing you. You pulled away from this person. That's why they have you on a pedestal with admire, and that's the challenge. This person is used to being chased by family, friends, and otherwise. Like, this person is used to being the one pursued. Maybe they were taught they were pretty or cute or, you know, handsome or whatever, beautiful, and people fawned over them. Oh, you know, I want them in my presence because they're cute. So they go hang out with these people that want to be associated with your person based on maybe looks or how cool they are or unique they are or whatever. So they were used to people chasing them, not the other way around. In the hidden energy, they are secretly chasing you energetically. You know, if this person has come to you, you feel them, they're chasing you energetically. Again, they're watching you in whatever way that's possible. Tell me more, Spirit. Palm tree. Stability, security, permanence, growth, endurance, and flexibility. Yeah. So when I see stability and security, this person sees you as no place like home. You are stability. You are the grounding force in their life. You endured. And you were flexible. So like, you are the type of person to bend backwards for this person and to accommodate them and help them if they needed it. You attended to this person when they couldn't attend to themselves. Tell me more, Spirit. Lightning. Sudden change. Oh, shocking news, epiphany, upheaval, and transformation. Listen, your person is having a tower moment. And things are suddenly changing right now. You may hear from this person out of the blue. Also, they're getting shocking news in their life. So whatever they thought was the way it is, it's no longer that way. And it's kind of jarring their world. It's kind of the energy that's like, I get a sense of hurt and surprise. I get disbelief, you know, like this is like an incredulous situation. Like, this can't be what I'm experiencing. Like, this is not real. So if they had you in a third party situation, I get that wherever they are, whatever they're doing, they didn't expect things to go down in the way that it did, right? This is somebody who is like shocked by the outcome of something. Also ready to bolt, ready to move on, ready to transform. So there's a lot going on in this person's life. Bottom of the deck, passion and seeing chemistry, like each other, equally having fun. So remember I said that this person had a passionate relationship with you, but they were inconsistent. This person is ignited by you. You know, they feel something. It's a little extra. It's a little different. It's unlike anybody else ever in their life. But they keep giving you passion and not giving you love. Now, love is a stable frequency. As long as the person who is exhibiting love understands what love really is. But this is someone here who's passionate. So your passions last as far as your interests last. When you're no longer interested in a particular thing, then you're no longer passionate about it. How many times have you picked up a little art project and decided I'm going to do this, and either you didn't open the box or the whatever it was, or you started it and just there was one more step, you just put it down. You were over it. And this person is a put it down kind of person. They will start something and they don't finish it. Passion. Now you can have, like this says, insane chemistry, like each other, equally having fun. But fun is where it kind of ends with this person. They don't really take it further than that because they're too busy attending to too many. I think this person is, there's a lot of codependency on other people, especially with the chaser. They, this person people pleases, honestly. Yeah. And they love you. Lovers with the Queen of Cups. They do love you. I feel like they do choose you, but their actions and their words need to line up. Tell me more about these healthy choices. So your person learned a serious lesson. What is that? Oh, that's a whole deck. I can't take that. But I did see the Three of Swords. Your person is learning a serious lesson. I think your person learned that this passion that they have for you, coupled with love, it's kind of like with them not having your vibration in their life, it's like they now know that whatever you tried to teach them is true. Whatever they experienced with you is real. And that they didn't give you enough because they were being irresponsible. Tell me my story. Yeah. So in the pride and ego this person had, they just can't figure some things out when it comes to me. Eight of Wands. Yep. I knew it. Oops. Four of Wands. The Wheel of Fortune. Something is changing. There's instability where your person is. Home life. Remember I said you are like home to them. Home life is not doing well. They want to communicate with you. That's why they want to set up a date when you guys can talk. This person, I get the feeling that they realize where they went wrong with you. Now, they may not fully understand because I'm getting, they don't know what to do. I'm not ready to grow up. They may not fully understand or comprehend the gravity of what they did. But they do know that they want to talk to you, and they do know that now they want to express themselves. But, you know, I get a feeling that you may hear them out, but at the same time, words will not be enough to quell whatever's going on between the two. Tell me more, please. Yeah. Okay, so when this tower comes, this lightning bolt comes, it's about them break them free from whatever hold that they had on them, whatever was keeping them stationary, thinking about a situation, but not taking any action. But the Hangman is in reverse, so there's a release. They've already seen a different side. They already have a different perception of something. Bottom of the deck. Yeah. Now they want to work with you, but this person is passionate. Remember, this person is passionate, but they are inconsistent. So them saying, oh, I want to work on this, I would take pause. I would pray about it, use my personal discernment. I'd get a reading if I had to, but I would check that out. Are they really serious about working with me and letting go of a third party? Because it looks like they are, but the lightning bolt and the Hangman. But, you know, people can argue and get back together. So they need to show something to prove to you this is not a go back around. This is not a spin the block. This is not to see if I'm going to be hooked to you. And the only way I think would validate that is you standing your ground. So, you know, take out resonates collector. This person, their whole life is being shooken up. The Wheel of Fortune is here and the challenge and the lesson. So they got blessings. They got changes coming through in their life. However, they're learning that they should have cooperated with you, that they were passionate. They couldn't make up their mind because they still wanted to be a player or a kid, you know, immature. They didn't want a man up or woman up in your situation. This person is definitely learning some serious lessons, either about dealing with you or life in general. I feel like they're experiencing some karma. And they're ready to cooperate, Spirit said, but everybody's situation is different. This is giving me pause. I mean, I don't know what kind of epiphany that they have with this lightning bolt. And it says epiphany, surprise, upheaval, transformation. They're going to make a mighty change. Something major is going to happen. And they're going to come share with you that they want to cooperate with you. But again, what does it look like? Because what did you tell them? You had to have told them something. So reflect back on that. What was your last conversation like? What did you explain that you needed or required? And have they done any of that? Because if the answer is, I don't know, or no, they haven't done anything, then that's clarification that whether or not this person has changed. So take it how it resonates. If it doesn't resonate, don't take it. Please remember to like, click, share, and subscribe to the channel. Peace.